Hey everybody, this is Moose, and I am joined once again by the very handsome Hein of Looking Handsome. Today we are going to do our episode of Heinsight on PL Borneo V3. This has been chosen as a map for Week 8. Originally it was Deadwood. Before that, what was it?
Cashworks,
but both of those maps ran into problems, so we are running Borneo kind of last minute. I think the announcement came out a couple days ago, about a week ago. However, that's not going to stop us from having a lot of fun on this map. What are we looking at today, Hein?
Oh, I guess we're going to do the typical defense holds, offensive pushes, and then we'll go over some class-specific things that people need to focus on to help their teams out the most. And we'll just go point by point, kind of saying what doors open up, when what cap is taken, etc.
Sounds pretty good to me, dude. We are on the first point right now. You can see the outline of the board when Hein is looking at it. That is the first point where you're looking at blue spawn right now. This first point, uphill fight, kind of up through the barn area, or the shed area up there. What can you see working for the offense since you're on blue? Let's go ahead and start with that. Or let's start defense, because it's easier to talk about, like, where to expect holds.
Okay, that's fine with me.
Yeah, we'll play offense off of that.
Your team basically needs to decide which form of payload you want to play. Like, what kind of map you're most familiar with. So, if your team is good at upward, kind of treat this as if it's upward. Or if you're really good at badwater, treat it like it's badwater. And then from that, change your strategy to morph to this map. So if you're on, say, upwards, and you put a gun up near their spawn, and you just expect it to get trashed on, but you just want to waste their time, then do that. Try it in a bunch of different spots. There's a lot of different areas over here. There's a lot of good sight lines. Or treat it like bad water, where you want to hold that first point as long as possible, if not the entire time. Or do a mix of both. You can do really whatever works the best for your team. And just kind of move from there. And I think this first point might be defensible for the entire time. Just because of this little area right here. It's going to take some really aggressive pushes from the offense in order to get past this area. And you might just be able to get some lucky picks and get away with it. So There's a lot that you can do. So I guess we'll kind of go over it class by class just for this first area, because once you get past this first area, it's more a big zone that you want certain classes to look at, but this is kind of a little bit smaller line, so you need each class to know what they're looking for, what they're going after, what exactly they need to do. Because you don't want to get in the situation where someone's just kind of running around, they just have no idea what they're doing other than stopping a car. That's kind of the generic. But if each person has a specific role that they want to do, they'll be more focused on exactly what they want to do. And the main caller doesn't really have to say, hey, why aren't you over there? Or why don't you go do this? It can just be, I already know what I'm doing. I don't have to worry about the rest of the team. I can just focus on living. And that's coming from the medic's point of view, because you don't want to constantly have to tell everyone what to do, because that really gets old. So just try to take the initiative and kind of figure out what you should be doing. And for the demo and the soldier, the main thing that they want to do is spam out the area around the cart so no one can stand near it, or spam the doors so that they just can't get out. So say at the very start, you just want to have your soldier up here. He can shoot down on this door or that door, and that's going to make them more hesitant to go out those doors. So be mindful of that. Sit stickies where people can see them. Say you put them on two doors, and we'll use this side as an example as well. You've got stickies all over the floor down here, so they know, hey, there's stickies here. We either need to shoot him out of the way or pop an Uber to get out. But then over on another door, say that one right there, you can hide them along the top rim. And since they see them down there, they might not expect them to be up there. So you can kind of trick them a little bit. And just try to think outside of the box. For this map, because it's not really like a whole lot of other maps. This is a big choke area right here. So you can basically just funnel them through and keep the spam going. Scout, I would say, needs to be constantly on the move, always moving through these houses, jumping around, just making sure that the spy doesn't have an easy time to get to the engineer. So anywhere you can think of that the spy can get and hide, and dead ring or cloak and dagger, you want to just start shooting those boxes, shooting everywhere you can, just to make sure that he can't have it easy. And of course you never want to, because spy is easy enough with a stupid dead ringer. So make his life hell, jump around all you can. If anybody's on the cart and you can get this hide advantage, use it and just juke around. There's really no stopping you from running away. So if you're getting hurt, just run away. There's no point in dying suiciding for one kill, because a 1-to-1 kill as defense is not usually worth it, but it's definitely worth it on offense because you almost instantly spawn. So watch out for that. The sniper has some pretty good sight lines from way back here, so watch out for that. He's also got a little bit of view on here, especially over there. We've tested it out and it is perfectly fine to do a headshot from right there or up here. Just kind of just look around. Snipers tend to do whatever they want anyways, so just get them overhealed, make sure they have ammo, and you're fine. Engineer spot. This is very important for all payload maps, which I've gone over in Barn Blitz, but your engineer can make or break your team. If he does not move back fast enough and he gets killed, you're pretty much not going to be able to keep a very strong hold. And if their team is really, really strong and that gun goes down, they could possibly wipe your team and push all the way to second, which would give that to them free as well. So think of spots. If you're not going to do the decoy spot, or I guess if you are going to do the decoy spot, you need to make sure that he can get up a level 3 as quickly as possible in a good spot that's relevant, and it won't just instantly get taken down. And don't panic if your second one does get taken down. Just keep moving. Just get out of there as quick as you can. Rely on your team to put down some focus fire so you can get out and go ahead and build back a second or third if that's the case. And just like usual, you want to have your heavy and medic comboed up on here. Just the power duo is pretty strong to break. And throw in some pyro and you've got it even more strong. Or stronger, if you like English. Which I like sometimes. You can have him float if you want your pyro to float. Just remember, he's very squishy and he can die very easily to pretty much every single class. But you know, sacrificing your pyro to do a bigger goal, it works. And if you can figure out what I'm talking about, then you've probably already played against us with Fathom. And Fathom is relentless with how he does things. So he'll be very aggressive and give us that buffer effect that's far in front of us. And then when he dies, we already know that they're damaged enough that sometimes we can just push on in and kill whatever he had already set up damaging. And we know the medic can really only heal one person at a time, so if 3 or 4 people are on fire, might as well push on through and just hope for the best, especially if you know that he killed a few. So be mindful of that. Tank your pyro on these. If you're holding back real far and you just want to hold this point really bad, just pop your Uber and push straight down through. If you're doing that, your main goal is to force them to also pop. So if you're popping on your pyro, you need to let him understand that he's going to be basically sacrificed, and you're going to get right back out while he's sitting up there air blasting their Uber back. And that's the key to payload. We went over this on Barn Blitz, and I'll probably go over this every single payload we ever do. But the goal of defense is to force them to pop their Uber before they ever get to the gun. Unless it's a decoy, of course. It's common sense. So if you've got your gun way back here on the house, which it could work, I guess, you got pretty decent sight lines, and you know that you want to hold this, then you need to make sure that you can somehow make them pop Uber in this region, right up here. And watch out for direct hit soldiers way back here. And if that's the case, and you know you're going to put it there, and you know that their soldier could possibly do that, then have the pyro over here and directing back. Or have him stand right here, so when they come, he can direct him back down at the cart. So he can kind of use his own rockets against his own team. And think, if they do this, then I should do this. And then, if you change yours to do that, then you need to also go back against that and say, what if they do that to us? What will we do then? So it's constantly an if-then statement over and over and over. And the more you do that, the more options your team knows what they can counter and how to counter it. But if you go in thinking, this is our strat, it has to work, and if it doesn't, we're screwed, then more than likely your strat's not going to work unless it's just incredibly awesome. And if it fails, you're kind of floundering. Your team's going to panic, they're going to get scared, and they're going to play a lot more passive. And when I say scared, I don't mean like fear of clowns or spiders or anything, but I mean they're afraid to go out and get killed, so they're going to instinctively play more defensive. And you want to instill that fear in the other team. Like, for instance, our team, Looking Handsome, we're known for being aggressive. And that kind of aggression is incredibly powerful when teams know that you're aggressive. So what you can do is you can turn that on other teams and play passive at certain points, and they won't know what to do. They're going to be expecting something so big, and it's not going to be there, so they'll sit and wait. So if you're on defense and they expect you to push in on them and force an Uber or something like that, and you don't, that's them wasting their time longer and longer. So it could work out for you. So just know how your team's dynamics flow and work with it. But this first point, you know, I've kind of gone over the majority of the classes that really matter. The soldier, spy, and sniper, pretty much on all these maps, they have one role, so don't really change it. Their role is to kill people on the cart and to stall. Everyone else kind of has their own main job, like medic has his job of maintaining the team's health, heavy's the tank, engineer gets his gun up, pyro spy checks, whatever, you know what I'm saying. So just make sure everyone knows what they're doing, and this strategy for this first area should fall into play. The biggest thing that can hurt this point is the gun spot. So if you're going to spend time on anything, focus on the gun spot. So I can kind of go over that a little bit and help you form a strategy. I'm not going to tell you what to do, but I'll show you bad spots and possible good spots. So first off, we'll go over some bad spots. You think this might be a good spot because, hey, if they pop out, it's gonna be great. They won't expect it. Well, once they get right back here, they're gonna see it before they can shoot it, and they can blind kill it. So that's a bad spot. Right here is also another pretty bad spot because not only does it not have any vision, but it's also an easy blind kill from right about here. You want to avoid spots where they can kill it without popping Uber. So right here is dead center of the map. It's got great vision right there and there and there. And it's going to reach everywhere. And if you wrangle it, it's going to be even harder to kill. But to counter that, you could come out this right door, pop in right here where there is no vision of it, and just put some grenades on it and drop it. Or peek here and put stickies on it and drop it. If your demo is good enough that he can peek a corner, which hopefully everybody's demo is good enough because that's pretty basic, then you know that's a bad spot. Have your engineer build up some guns and have your demo just see how easily it is to kill, and then you'll know it's a good spot. Back here, as I went over, this might be a good spot because it's really not easy for close range classes to kill. Like, demo man's not going to be able to kill this very easily. The soldier will have to shoot really long range. This is the kind of spot where you're going to need to send your spy in to distract and sap, and then you push in. Or just go the easy route and Uber in. So you would come out this far door and cut in and Uber and take it. This is where the teamwork part of Hat Fortress 2 comes in, where you know your engineer is going to be vulnerable to Uber, so you put some kind of meat shield in front of him. Usually that's going to be your pyro. So once you know he's doing that, call your pyro over and have him air blast him back down and just waste that. One air blast straight back, all the way back down there, is going to probably waste 4 or 5 seconds of the 8 seconds if they don't spread around, and you'll be okay. One of the strongest ones would be back in this region, back here. Just think about sniper sight lines, having your engineer killed, especially if he uses Wrangler. You know that he's going to be bait for snipers, so think about this spot. It's really not that strong because it does have good sight lines, but it's not going to have far enough sight lines. So it's not going to shoot unless you wrangle it. So just think about that when you're putting together a gun. Another one could be this one. It's kind of like on Dust Bowl last point, where they have to really have a concerted effort to push. There's really no gigantic sight lines except way over there and on the cart, but it's one of those that they have to creep around a corner to get. So they could possibly have to pop an Uber for it. And it's, I'm not gonna tell you what's right or wrong, but this is also one of those really cool spots where if it is getting shot and you know it's gonna get taken down, just pick it up, back up, and then leave. Come back here, set it up right here, or somewhere like that. You always want to think of an escape plan for your engineer where he can get out and he can go to the next point. If you build a gun right here, it's kind of a bad spot, but he's also got it where he can move off to the left, avoid sniper lines, and he's out. So take that kind of thinking to the next point. And if you can learn what spots are good and bad, then you'll be able to mold it into the next map. Say we play another custom map, some other season that's not bad. You can go into it and say, I've never played this before, but using some common sense and normal game sense, I know I can get shot by this, this, and this class. I can put it in this spot and counter it only be vulnerable to spy. And that's the main thing you want, is to have it where mainly the spy is the main thing that's going to be able to kill you. So just think about that, and that's going to help you out a lot. That's a lot of talking.
That is a lot of talking. That sounds good for the first point. A lot of this is really going to convert to the second, third, and fourth points. So I guess we're going to try to keep those brief, because a lot of them are just going to be the same thing. It's a lot of zone defense. You're going to... want to put your classes in a position where they're able to do their jobs, like Hein said earlier, without having to sacrifice for kills. However, each point does deserve a quick run through and just a little bit of direction, because, you know, we do have a bunch of newer teams in Highlander. A lot of them are going to be asking for some of that positioning, so I don't know, just continue.
We should annotate in the YouTube that I'm a box right now, and I'm on a shelf.
Are you? Yes, you are. Look at that one pink-hatted, handsome box.
Yeah. This one is a pretty fun map. Well, not map, but area. And it's not very easy for an offense to push on this, I think, if a defense can get set up properly. So... what I'll say is, once this is capped, this door opens. And that's a big deal. And so does this one. So basically what that's doing is, that's making it where your defense can go all the way through those two doors and go up to there. And up there is right here, where that door also opens. So not only can the offense flank through that side, but the defense can flank through. And I say that because if you're wanting to think aggressively, you want to get them as far away from that point as possible, and you want an escape. So you can still hold this area. I don't know if I would hold this far forward, but you could always fall all the way forward here for a crits, if you had crits, and surprise them back here. Say the card's right here, and they're all focused on it, or they've got their little base right up here, and you just killed their medic, and they're kind of just, they're trying to formulate a plan while they're waiting. Well, if you push in on them and wipe them, that's going to make it even worse. And then the medic's still sitting back at spawn alone, waiting for people to spawn. So you can do quite a bit of work. Soldiers can rocket jump right here and go over and shoot down here. It's a lot like how it was on King of the Hill Waste, where there was a good wall that you could rocket jump and get a vantage point. That's pretty fun. I like that. And there's this whole area way back here that you can look at. There's health, there's metal, there's a flank route low. You can get up here from the top ground. You can flank from down here. If you somehow fall down here, you got boxes you can get back out.
Utilize all stairs.
But you could utilize all of this trash area that most people are going to just ignore. But if you can form a good push off of this, and they've got a gun up here, you might be able to just fully push in on them and they won't expect it. Just make sure you get some kind of diversion going up here that will allow them to push through. So maybe it's your heavy medic pyro that go through the back way, and you've got your demo up here spamming, your soldier, your scout, just kind of dance around, pushing in, goes and just sacrifices himself. Just like have your demo or your soldier jump up high. Maybe the gun will pick them off, but if people are looking up high, they're not looking over there. So that misdirection is going to be really great. And try to use that as much as you can, because misdirection is so key on so many maps, and people just tend to not even think about it. They push in one door when there's three or four doors. Use all of them. Use all four doors. Thinking of Obscure, with what we did on Obscure, was when we were pushing to that last point, it's such a pain. But if you switch it up and make it where it works for your team, it's so much better. And what we would do is we would send in two people the top side, two people on the right side, and then the rest go through the middle. And all the caller has to do is say, go. You don't have to tell it people last minute. Just have everyone know, this is your point, this is your point. Don't push in until I say so. If you're not alive, just have us wait, and then we all push in together. And then you got nine people shoving in, and they're not going to know where to look. They're going to be kind of going one way or the other. And if they're focused on one, that means their back is turned to someone else. So utilize that. It's really fun. It takes a little bit of coordination, but not that much coordination. Don't overcomplicate it, and you'll be okay. Just say, hey, soldier, go to this door every single time. Or scout, flank this way every time. And then really your caller has it much easier, just like I said on the first point. This is a lot the same. So as we were saying with sentry gun spots, this could be a good gun spot, or it could be terrible. And if we had a way to have people answer why it's terrible, that would make it great, but we don't. So that's not gonna work. You could put it here. It's got moderate sight line, but you gotta watch the backside, which could work, you know. There's a gun spot you could do here. You could do a gun spot here. It's kinda on its own, but they have to fully breach this whole area. And this kind of vision means that they're visible to all of this. And that could work in your favor. So level 3's there. Even many sentries have worked there from what I've seen in a lobby or two. Find all the places you can jump on. Find all the places you can build stuff on. Like, I know for a fact you can build on these. So would this be a good gun spot? Probably not, but maybe it will in other parts of the map. So, look around. Don't fall in the pit like I almost did. And I think this is a defensible spot. If you can range people from all the way over here, using that flank route, and then have others up here, or your demo spamming through right here, that's going to give you the chance to spam, put out some damage on them, make them have to regroup. If they want to push with their heavy, and you hit him in the face with a few grenades, that could either make them fall back and wait, which is great for you because you want to waste time, or it's going to force them to pop Uber way up here, which is awesome, and it's exactly what you want. Or if you put stickies up there, you can dead them and get a few really awesome kills. You could put sneaky stickies there. Just be very precise with them. Be good at hiding the one in there. And then if you've got your gun way back here, there's no way they're going to get all the way over there. Now, one thing you might want to watch out for is a demo man right here spamming over the top. So watch out for that. But if your defense is set up very spaciously, and say you've got your sniper way back there, he's going to be in prime view, and he's going to be looking up here, and the misdirection is going to be back there this time. It's going to play in your favor. So you could put guns in very obvious spots that might not work, but then again, with certain teamwork, it might work perfectly. So that's the spot. There's a lot of fun things up here that you can do. And I don't want to pigeonhole anybody. I could go over a definite strategy, but I think it'd be better if teams kind of learned it for themselves. And maybe we might do an advanced tactics after this, kind of like we did Canal Zone, just since it is so random. And this is in the running for Season 8, so if more people understand how to play it, then maybe, you know, we might actually get it voted in.
Can be a nice break from Upward.
Yeah, Upward's great, but man, 4 seasons in a row, 5 seasons in a row.
That would change. As far as I'm going to throw in my personal experience with this map in here, first points and third points are really kind of the easiest to defend. If a team can breach where you're at right here on offense, usually they'll make it through the tunnel. Usually the red team's completely wiped or so hurt that they have to fall back all the way past the second point out through the tunnel that you're got you back to. But that also makes the third point very defensible, so let's go ahead and run through that real quick. And just from my experience, top right works as a sentry spot. Right underneath the stairs you can get a good wrangler down all the way down the tunnel if you can get your engineer built back as you're getting by those leaves, so it can be hard for a team to see you coming. Or up top right up by that rock, right by your first spawn. Anywhere behind that building you're going to be set, so
and you got an escape route.
And you've got an escape route, so it works out pretty nice. And there's another barn I'm sure you'll run through that's really very defensible. The one you're running through now. Obvious sentry spots up top and right where you're at. But let's go ahead and run through that real quick. What do you think?
I agree. I was running on this with D9, who's a pretty fun steel clan, and they were thinking this would be a really great gun spot right here. And it is. It's a very great gun spot. But one thing that was really funny was their engineer was standing right on top of this. And I was like, oh, okay, well, all right, that works. And I was like, well, you got to watch out for snipers. He's like, okay, well, I'll move right here and stand on top of the gun. And what I did after that was I went all the way through way back here, and all you could see from right here was the top of his head. And we went spy, and Ambassador killed him in the head. It was pretty funny. But you gotta think like that. You always gotta find good counters to things. And it is a good spot. I think it's a very good spot. But just don't stand on top of it. And now that I said that, hopefully no one will do that. And I'm probably ruining it for everyone. But I know D9's not gonna put their gun there. So, it's all good. I don't know if we can stand in any of these trees like we can at the first point.
I tried using a sticky jumper into them. I couldn't do it. I don't think it's possible.
Well, that first part, it's just a little limb. Yeah, whatever. But yeah, this is another spot that I think you can hold really well. Mainly because they've only got two ways to come in. You got a really long sight line that's going to be great for snipers. Huntsman, actually, would be really good on this one. And sentry guns, so you basically have this one blocked by two people. So you could have everybody else kind of chilling in here, just as a cutoff point, or all the way back up here. There's no reason not to hold this point, even though it got capped, because it's a pretty strong defensible point. So find a good place that your team likes to hold, and just stay with it, or go all the way back here, and just wait, and then push in. You could hold this tunnel. Put your gun back here, watching these ways. There's a lot of different areas that you could go through. There's no right way to play this map, I think. There's so many really good ways to play it. You could put a gun spot here and watch everything. You could put a gun spot here like right here and watch all the way down the tunnel, even peeking in, they're not going to really be able to do it because they're just going to get instantly shot. If you like that kind of spot and you like it a little bit more forward, then by all means use it. But remember, if they pop Uber on it, it's going to immediately go down. And it's kind of hard for your team to block it. So, fork your defense. Split it as much as you can. Make it where it can work for you. A gun spot way back here could work out really well. It's more of a defensive hold, relying on 8 of your players to be the defense and your 9th to be back here, kind of holding down the fort, making himself spy bait so the rest of the team can wait. Because more than likely, if your gun's way back here, the team's going to want to get it down instead of focusing on the card itself. So just think of that. Think of baiting one class out to force their team to focus on it. So just think about that. And this pull point, kind of, I think it's going to be really easy to hold if you do it correctly.
And if you get wiped even trying to come out of the tunnel, the inside of the house that you're in or on top of now, very easily defensible. You ran in there real quick. That door will open, making it a little bit more difficult. But if you get a sentry up where he's shooting, get it up to level 3, you can hold your defense, your heavy medic combo up on the stairs across from you. Your soldier inside somewhere in a corner, just spamming out corners, your pyro air blasting. I wasn't going to show him that spot because that's kind of my hiding spot, but yes, you can jump a soldier up there.
What spot? I was just shooting.
I'm sure you were.
I've shot a lot of things that would be hiding spots.
I don't think you can get back there, but so defense again works really well. It's a little bit more cramped in the third point, and they might be able to push it in towards the third cap, but after that, it's going to be really hard for them to get out, unless, again, you're disorganized or they wipe.
This is an interesting spot. This kind of reminds me of Barn Blitz.
Oh, yeah, right on the final point.
See if you can put a gun right there. It's not as awesome as it was on Barn Blitz, but, you know, it's one of those spots that you could definitely use. This is another one. Be kind of risky because you're right over them. Be fun for. I don't know if spies can get up here, can they?
Yep.
Yeah, I definitely did that in one jump. Okay, so that's about it for that. This whole area. And you'll notice there's no point out here. You're not defending a point, you're defending a zone. And when I was thinking about this, when I was building our strategy, was don't defend for points, defend for zones. And upward is a lot of the same way. Because when you're defending an area that there is no point, it's not as bad if you lose it, so falling back doesn't hurt you. So if you want to think about it that way, take out those 3 middle points on the middle and just focus on keeping them from getting as far as you can. So if you lose this little area, fall back to here. Set up another gun, hold this as long as you can, and then if you lose that, fall back up here. Build a gun. Once you lose that, fall back. So basically they're going through 15 stages all at once, and this relies heavily on your team knowing when to fall back and how to just get out of the area so they don't constantly die and feed the other team. Because the more you feed the other team, and I'm stealing that from Dota, but the more you feed, the less you have to defend with. So if you're constantly defending with 7 or 8 people, and they've constantly got 9 people, you're going to slowly lose more and more of the map. But if you can push them back long enough, and you can fall back another stage, you've got another one. So just this little area alone, you've got this area, you've got this area that you can do as a combo. You can move back here, hold this, put something up there, and something over there. You've got another area right here to fall back to as a little mini move. You've got this where you can watch the flanks. You can actually re-flank on them. Remember, you can always use the flanks against them. And you've got that up there, which is real strong because the height advantage is always definitely strong. And then you just keep going. This area right here is also kind of trash, but this is going to be used as an offensive push mechanism. And if you can get people on the cart, you can use this really long, wide way and get around them and hopefully drop behind. Maybe they'll have a gun back here watching for it, but you never know. You got to try it. And this little room right here is a good little hiding spot. If you want to set up a little base, you can get a little bit of height of advantage. It's not that big, but otherwise it's just kind of a useless little room. But I like it.
Again, in a scrim I played today, we were using that spot. The defense would be holding in on their last building up on that catwalk to the right of that door and inside, and we would just kind of build in that room and get ready. We'd send our soldier and our demo over to the right to push in from the right as we pushed in from the left and from main, and we were able to use that to our advantage. That room, not great for holding, definitely a great place to consider staging your offense for the final push.
I want to go up there.
I don't think you can.
No, but I want to.
Do you have a basher that you can bash or jump with?
No, but I can jump down this hole.
You'd die.
Nuh-uh. So this little area has a little bit of metal. There's one there, there's one up there, and you've got one back here. Health-wise, you got a baby one there, a bigger one back here. Otherwise, you kind of have to fall out. There's really not a whole lot that's here. It's pretty deprived, so if you think about strategically, you've got little small sight line. They're going to have to push through a bunch of different chokes. You might consider switching over to miniguns at this point. Once you've lost that real wide open jungle area and you get into this industrialized area, just consider switching over. And one thing I did last night in the lobby was, I got pigeonholed right here. The cart was right here. I had a little minigun, so I built it right here. And once it was built, I jumped on top of it and left. And got out, which I can't right now because I'm retarded. Oh, I unbound my crouch jump. But I just got out, got more metal, and then just left. Once they killed the gun, I dropped another one there, and I left. So, in a situation where I shouldn't have lived, I did live. Like that, which is awesome. But I think that's about it, because the last point is just one big choke. And you don't want to hold in that room at all. It's just a bad decision. So try to hold up as far forward as you can. Maybe only leaving a gun on the left or right side. And that's about it. So that's all I got for defense, I think.
Really, last hold, if you do really feel more comfortable sitting and smacking a level 3 wrench, and I know I just flew through here on my camera, I'm going to have to do it again. You have height advantage on the final point. You do have a catwalk up over here on the left. You have another bridge over on the right. You have a room over here which is strong for a dispenser. Your medic can hold up here on the top left. You hold a dispenser up here. He's clear from this left room. He can see the middle door, and he's clear from the right side. As long as he holds correctly within these pillars, no one can see him. And if someone does see him, he can just back right out into spawn or back out with his heavy.
I came all the way back because there was one thing I just remembered.
Go for it.
Think of these pillars when you're putting your gun down. Because if you're putting your gun down right here, you're basically blocking that whole door. And if you've got your gun right here, which seems like a really sick spot because you got two eyes on it, well, you're totally missing that other door. And all they have to do is use those pillars to their advantage and creep. And they can get right about here before it's even seen. So you can sticky that and pot it up and, you know, it's not too bad. So think of that when you're making it. So maybe put it way up here and you've got view on all of them, and have a little bit stronger of a defensive hold up here just so it kind of forces them onto the other side. And that's all I got for that. I think that's pretty straightforward. So
don't victory fall pay.
Victory
we
pay.
Had our heavy fall in the hole and he lost us the round because he was the only one up with the medic. Everyone else is 5 or 6 seconds out from respawn. By the time everyone respawned, the cart's sitting right here. And we were like, no! And they were able to push it in. We still ended up winning, but moot point, our heavy fell in the hole. That's really all about it for me as well. Play it a lot. You'll definitely notice you'll either fall into a barn or a, upward or bad water style defense. A little bit of Barn Blitz thrown in. This is a pretty vanilla payload map. This actually was a good choice. I kind of do like this after playing it once or twice. I thought it was going to be a crappy, stalematey map. It's not if your offense is set up correctly. And you like what I found personally is if you can break through a defense and you've got a couple of your heavies up with your medic, push forward. Let your scout, your engineer cap push forward. Get up to where you think they're going to defend next and scare them away from it, because they think you're going to have Uber. Even if you don't, sometimes feigning it can be really beneficial. Force them back. It can give you an extra free point and a half even, just by being proactive and getting your team up and ahead before the defense gets a chance to reorient themselves. So keep that in mind at any point. If you are healthy and you wipe, just keep pushing forward. Don't be passive, especially when you have the advantage, because it's just going to come back and bite you in the butt. Your medic will get sniped or something, and you're going to lose all that Uber, and then you're screwed. So just something to keep in mind. Yeah. Otherwise, I'm done.
With the map?
Well, with Heinsight, I've still got to do moose tracks. So I gotta come up with more things to talk about, which would be great. Oh, I didn't know you could stand there.
I didn't either.
Neat.
So yeah. Yeah, that's about it. They're basically doing your blitzkrieg, you just push all the way through. If you can wipe enough, push all the way to their second point and hold them off at their doors. And then you got 2 points for free. Then you just keep doing it over and over. Find out where they spawn at certain points when you cap certain areas, and just move on up to that next point.
I think there are only two for defense. I think the only two are the initial one here, overlooking the tunnel exit, and the final area back in the back. I'm not sure they get a third.
So it's the same as pretty much every other payload map where they've only got two?
Pretty much.
Right after the second point, and then last.
Yeah.
So yeah, there's really no good way to tell you how to push this. Because you gotta overcome this choke point, you gotta overcome going around the corner, and then this tiny little door, you gotta overcome that. Think of different flank routes on all the different ways. Use your spy to your advantage, as we use Bone Masher a lot. He'll cloak and dagger, and he'll just stand in an area for a while, and just kinda chill. Say, oh yeah, the medic's at 60% Uber, and they're holding way back. Go ahead and push in if you want to. Hein, you're really handsome. I like that call a lot. That's really, it's one of my favorites. So shout out to Bone Masher. And that's just about it. If you can get through this area and through the tunnel, you should be able to cap out the rest of the map. If not, then kind of figure out what you're doing wrong or what they're doing right. You're not always doing something wrong if you're losing. Sometimes they're just doing something extremely right, and you have to be able to figure that out. But I think I'm pretty much good to go on this one as well. It's a great map. Scenery's really well done. It's enjoyable.
Absolutely. Well, best of luck.
Talking about.
Best of luck to everyone this week. Final week of UGC Highlander Season 7 Summer League. We might see this map again eventually, depending on how much you guys like it. I really hope that we see it again. But even more so, we hope to see you again next season. Season 8 fall season is going to be great. We're going to have our medals back. We're going to have our playoffs back. It's going to be great. The UGC is just getting huge. It's getting to be a lot of fun. So come back and see us next season. Any final thoughts, or are you just about done?
Final thoughts. Get some good teams coming in. Give us something to fight. There's no good teams in UGC right now except Looking Handsome, so take that as your battle cry. Take offense. Get some great teams coming in. Maybe bring some good teams back. I hope Gangsta Gang Gaming comes back. They're pretty awesome. And shout out to D9. And I've got my pink gibbous on, so thanks, Fathead.
Woohoohoo! That sounds good to me. That is it for PL Borneo V3 Moose signing out.